There's a river flowing from the throne of God. Drink from the water right now. Oh, there's a river flowing from the throne of God. Drink from the water right now. It's a river of healing.
Morning, while it's still morning. Glory to God. Are you ready for the Word? I want you to open your Bibles to Hebrews chapter 1. Actually, chapter 2. That's where we started up last week. I just wanted to revisit that. And we'll look at a couple of foundational scriptures that we have looked at concerning this teaching on the fundamentals of faith. Glory to God. So we have it right here in Hebrews chapter 2. Beginning with the first verse, it says, therefore, we must give the more earnest heed to the things which we have heard, lest we drift away or lest we allow them to slip from us. Amplified reads it this way, for this reason, or that is, because of God's final revelation in his son Jesus, because of Jesus' superiority to the angels, we must pay much closer attention than ever to the things that we have heard, so that we do not in any way drift away from the truth. Well, you know, we're a church that's been labeled a word of faith church, a name it, claim it, blab it, grab it, and it's all true. Glory to God. Man, I just appreciate that label. That's good. I mean, if that's what we, people, but praise the Lord, you know. So we put a great emphasis on the message of faith, or what Paul referred to as the word of faith, in Romans chapter 10. So that's our history as a church. That's our mandate. That's our call to put an emphasis or a spotlight on the subject of faith. Amen? I think it's an important subject. Don't you think so? Amen. Doesn't the Bible tell us the just or the righteous shall live by faith? Didn't we establish the fact that when do we live? When do you live? Does anybody know when you live? You never live in the future. You never live in the past. Some people in their own mind maybe does. But for the most part, in reality, we live in the present constantly. So we're constantly living, right? And so the Bible tells us that the righteous shall live, and their constant living in the present shall be living by faith. Amen? And so if we're to live by faith, then we should find out what faith is. We should find out how faith comes. And we should find out how to release our faith, or how to operate the faith of God in our lives. Because our life literally depends on it. Your life depends on it. Your overall well-being depends on it. Amen? And so that's why the Lord has directed us to get back to teaching again on faith. You know, I've always kind of sprinkled every message with faith in it in some way. Because you have to mix faith with the Word of God. Amen? In order to receive the promises of God. There's a lot of folks I've heard over the years that say, you know, I know this person and they had a lot of faith and they still died of something, you know, whatever they said that they were believing God for. Well, that's possible that a person can, you know, have lots of faith and still die, because it's not just so much having lots of faith that's going to keep you alive. It's knowing what to do with the faith that you have lots of. Amen. The Bible says everybody's been given the measure of faith. And there's people that they can starve to death with a pocket full of money and grocery stores full of food. You know, I know this person, they starved to death. And they had all kinds of money and lived right next to Walmart. And the shelves were full. Wow. Well, I understand that. Just like a person, I know this person who had all kinds of faith and they still died. Here's the thing. You got to go into the store. In other words, you need to take some action. You need to walk. You know, maybe, or just drive. But you still got to walk. You got to do some action. You got to act on. You know, go to the store. And when you go to the store with a pocket full of money, you need to reach out and take what it is that you are desiring. Right? Put it in your cart. And then you walk it to the counter. And then you need to reach in your pocket and release your money, or spend your money on that particular thing that you have desire of need of. Well, people, we need to understand that we can have pockets full of faith. But if we don't take it out of our pocket and learn how to spend our faith, or release our faith, or put our faith to use, you can die without it. Amen. You can die with lots of faith. right? So that's what we're talking about here. We're talking about what faith is, how faith comes, and how to turn our faith loose in our lives. And you can't just cover it in one or two or three services. I can preach on for years and years along these lines. Amen? Glory to God. So say it with me. Say, I live by faith. I walk by faith, not by sight. I know the Bible says we walk by faith and not by sight or by our physical senses. Amen. And so we're going to look at some examples of that here in the Bible. So again, he said here, let us therefore give the more earnest heed to the things that we already have heard. Hallelujah. The word there, I find to be interesting, the word more earnest heed. More here, actually in the Greek says, to superabundantly hold the mind towards. Look at that. To superabundantly hold the mind towards something. It means also to apply oneself. To apply yourself. So we should all the more apply ourselves toward these things that we have heard, lest we let them slip away from and drift away from us. Amen? All right. Now going back over here, and we're going to come back to Hebrews chapter 1 here in a minute. We're in chapter 2, but we're going to come back to chapter 1 after we read from Hebrews chapter 11, which is one of our foundational texts. We find here in Hebrews 11 and verse 1, it says, now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. Now notice, it follows right after chapter 10 and verse 38 where it says, now the just or the righteous shall live by faith. If anyone draws back, my soul has no pleasure in him. Well, and then he goes on to say, now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. For by it the elders obtained a good testimony. So we see that there were others that lived by this faith. Now, the faith that he's talking about, what else does he say about this great faith? Look at verse 3. By faith we understand that the worlds were framed by the word of God, so that the things which are seen were not made of things which are visible. Then he goes on to say, by faith Abel. Verse 4, and then chapter, verse 5, and by faith Enoch, and then by faith, or without faith it is impossible to please him, for he who comes to God must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of them who diligently seek him. Then next one, verse 7 says, by faith Noah, and then verse 8 says, by faith Abraham, then 9, by faith they dwelt in the land, and by faith Sarah. So there's a whole list of people that operated in this same faith, listen, the same faith that created the worlds. The same faith, by faith, this faith. This is the faith that Jesus, the Bible says, is the author and finisher of this faith. And he says that we run our race based upon this faith. Now, we understand, of course, and I've said it to you before in laying this foundation, according to Romans chapter 10 and verse 17, it says faith comes by what? Come on. Faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. All right? So if faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God, God speaks and faith comes to our heart, then we need to also understand that the principles of faith operate the same way. Faith goes by speaking. Faith goes forth and produces results by speaking, because it was God who spoke the worlds into existence through faith and words. Words and faith. Are you listening? And the scripture tells us very clearly over there in Ephesians chapter 4, I believe it is, in 4, it says that we're to be imitators. Be imitators of God as dear children. Huh? Be imitators of God as dear children. Children, walk in love as God also loved us and gave his son as a sacrifice and an offering for us. Amen. So the Bible tells us that faith works by, come on, help me, works by love. Amen. You know, faith, hope, love, these three, but the greatest of these is love. But there's one thing the Bible says that pleases God, pleases God. Faith pleases God. But we have to understand that faith worketh by love. So you know that there's a love thing going on where your faith is concerned. Amen? Hallelujah. So again, looking what he says here in the Amplified, I read to you last week here in the Amplified, It says, now faith is the assurance, the title deed. I love that. And I shared with you that faith operates on the principle of ownership. Amen. If you bought a home and you pay off the home, what is it that you get? What do you burn? You burn the mortgage, but you don't burn the title deed. Amen. Because that's what you paid for. All right. So you burn the old mortgage, but you got what do you have in possession? You receive what is called the title deed for that home, which is proof and evidence of ownership. Amen. So when it comes to the promises of God, God has paid for it all and given it all to you, and you got the title deed on all the promises. You're an owner. Amen. So faith operates on the principle of ownership, meaning this, that we, whatever it is that we're believing God to manifest in our life, is something that we already possess and own through the finished work of the Lord Jesus Christ. He's already finished the complete work, and he has completely saved us, completely and totally, spirit, soul, hello, and body. And in every realm, he's produced salvation for us where relationships are concerned. Did you know there's salvation concerning that? Amen? As long as you have two parties that are willing to work together in agreement. You can't go against a person's will. Amen? And our salvation is complete concerning wellness and wholeness too. Hallelujah. Aren't you glad for that? Hallelujah. Our salvation is complete concerning financial, prosperity and blessings. That's right. We're one of those churches too. Glory to God. You one of them prosperity? Yeah, I am. We ain't going to preach poverty, do you? You want me to preach poverty to you? I don't have to preach it to you. It's preached to you all day long, everywhere you go. Amen. People always speak lack and death and doubt and unbelief, but that's not the language Jesus spoke. That's not the language of our inheritance. Death, doubt, and unbelief is not a part of the language of our inheritance. Amen. Our inheritance is wholeness and wellness and salvation and peace and joy unspeakable and full of glory. Yes. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. There's no lack where God is concerned. Amen. You start hanging around with him and spending time with him, you'll start thinking differently, talking differently, walking differently, acting differently. Hey, praise God. What's up with this guy? Whew, it's not what's up. It's he's up. Amen. Glory to God. So looking right again, what he says here concerning the Amplified, it says, now faith is the assurance, the title deed. Faith is the confirmation of things hoped for and or desired or whatever you have a vision for. And the evidence of things not seen. Meaning this, it's the conviction of their reality. I have a conviction that these things are real. I have a conviction that God is real. Without faith, it is impossible to please him. For he that cometh to God must believe that he is real. That he is. And he's a rewarder of those who diligently seek him. Faith says God is real in this situation. All situations. He's real. He's real. More real than the circumstance that I'm against. You know, it's about time that we put pressure on our circumstance. We're not supposed to be under the circumstance. We're supposed to put pressure on our circumstance by the word of faith in our mouth. Are you listening today? Amen. Praise God. I might start getting loud here in a minute. Hey, come on now. Glory to God. Look at this here. Again, Amplified. It's the conviction of their reality. I have a conviction. That's what the word faith actually means. It means conviction, a conviction in the truthfulness of God. A person that walks and lives by faith toward God, walks in a conviction that God's is true. Let God be true and every man or every port a lie if it doesn't line up with the covenant of God. Amen. God's true in this situation. Amen. Praise the Lord. All right. Look what else it says. For by this kind of faith, the men of old gained divine approval. Hallelujah. Verse 3, by faith, this is again amplified. By faith, that is, with an inherent trust and enduring confidence in the power, wisdom, and goodness of God, we understand. By faith, we understand that the worlds, the universe, the ages were framed and created and formed and put into order and equipped with their intended purpose by the word of God. We all just give the short version of it. We understand by faith, we understand that the worlds were framed and created by the word of God. So, come on, help me. So that what is seen, you got it up there? So that what is seen was not made of things which are visible. So what is seen was not made by things which are seen. Amen. The Bible says God is a spirit. He is not seen, but he's real. And he's more real than everything you can touch, you can see, or you can feel. He is more real. His word that was spoken is not seen, but the results are real. They're visible. You're sitting on it right now. I'm talking about the chair. And everything else he made too. Glory to God. Amen. God's an abundant God, isn't he? Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. See, the invisible words, invisible things that you cannot see, created the things which are seen. And then he tells you and I to live and walk by that faith. Hey, glory to God. Amen. No situation is too hopeless. All right. Hallelujah. As long as you have breath and you're alive on this earth, there's hope in this world. Are you listening? Amen. Glory to God. Now, I want you to go with me to Hebrews chapter 1. Go back there to Hebrews. We were in Hebrews 2, but we're going to go back to Hebrews 1. Picking up the first verse, goes right along with what we just read here. It says, God, who at various times and in various ways spoke in time past to the fathers by the prophets, has in these last days spoken to us by his Son, whom he has appointed heir of all things, through whom also he made the worlds. How did he make the worlds? Through who? Through his Son. Everything that we see, by faith the worlds were framed by the word of God. And who was it? It was his Son, Jesus, that was there speaking and created and framed the worlds. Glory to God. That, right here, let's read some more. And he is the heir. He has appointed him to be what? Come on. Heir of all things, through whom also he made the worlds. Well, the Bible says, if you belong to Christ, then you are Abraham's seed and heir according to all the promises of God. Then we find out over there in Hebrews chapter 8 and 9, it talks about an eternal inheritance that shall not be taken away from us, that Jesus came and he gave us. Through faith in him, he has given us an eternal inheritance. So Jesus is the heir, and we are, the Bible says, joint heirs with Christ. Say, I am. A joint heir with Jesus Christ. Say it with me. Jesus is the heir of all things. All things. Amen. I want you to know God didn't give you a bad inheritance. He gave you a good inheritance. Glory to God. Heir of all things. Praise the Lord. Amen. All things. And the Bible says that God is good. And there is no darkness in him at all. And any evil that comes your way, the Bible tells us it did not come from him. He is the Bible says that every good gift, listen, every good gift and every perfect gift is from above and comes down from the Father of lights, in whom is no variableness, neither shadow of turning. And that, you know, you're going to go through tests and trials and tribulations. Amen. Jesus said, in the world you shall have tribulation. But you're in this world, but not of this world. And cheer up, by the way. I think when he said that, there might have been a pause. There might have been a pause. He says, in the world you'll have tribulation. Pause. Bummer. Then Jesus said, what did he say? He said, cheer up. Cheer up. I have overcome the world. The point is this, I'm going to paraphrase based upon what we just read and what I just said. If he says, I have overcome the world, that means that you and I are in the I that have overcome the world. Because the Bible says we're in him and he is in us. And if he's the heir of all things, and that means he has left us a great inheritance. Amen. All right. So where does faith come in? Faith comes in and takes it. Faith believes and receives what belongs to it. Amen? Hallelujah. All right. You're all quiet on me, but that's okay. You can be if you want to be. Amen. Look at this. And so he's the heir of all things, through whom also he made the world, who, being in the brightness of his glory and the express image of his person. Jesus is the expression of the Father's heart toward you and toward me. That's a good report, isn't it? He's the expression of the image of the person and upholding all things by the word of his power. When he had, Jesus had by himself purged our sins, sat down at the right hand of the majesty on high. Amen. Praise God. Do you know the Bible promises us, because we're in covenant with, that we're the head and not the tail? That's what he said. We're above and not beneath. Glory to God. I'm blessed going into that dealership, and I'm blessed going out of that dealership. Hallelujah. Glory to God. You're the head, not the tail. You're the top and not on the bottom. You're on the top of the board, not on the bottom of the board. Are you listening? I used to be in the car business. I understand these things. Amen. Come on. Praise God. But that's the word of God. So what is it? The Bible says when we walk by faith, the faith that pleases God is a faith. Listen to me. It's a faith that agrees with God. Because that really is what the definition of walking by faith and living by faith is bringing your life into an agreement with the word of God. And the Bible says to hold fast our confession of faith. The word to hold fast, confession of faith, the word confession there simply means to say the same things. So God encourages us through the apostle, hold fast, listen, hold fast to saying the same thing God says. On any situation, on any subject in your life. That's why there's an emphasis in the Bible on faith and confession. Hold fast your confession or your profession of faith. Amen. Jesus is our high priest. And the Bible said, listen, he's the high priest over our proclamations. He's the high priest over our confession. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hold fast to it. Don't back off. Don't waver. Stay at it. Amen. We have a wonderful example in the Bible of someone who was persistent in their faith, and God honored him, and his name is Abraham. God first spoke to him when he was 75. I believe it was 75 years old. He told him to get out of the land. I love this. Get away from your family. Praise the Lord. Amen. Of course, he couldn't control who was going to follow him or not, so Lot followed. Right? Get away from your family. That's what God told Abraham. Get away from your family. Get away. No, love your family, folks. No, don't misunderstand me. I don't want anybody bailing on their family. Pastor Dave told me to leave you. I'm out of here. I didn't say that. Right? But he spoke to him. And then, you know, the Lord manifested to him. He made a covenant with Abraham. And I believe it was between one visitation that he received and a directive, a word from God that he received. And another was 25 years. Abraham stood for 25 years and believed God concerning a child. Amen. Most people can, you know, go 2 or 3 weeks or a day sometimes. Oh, God ain't answered yet. You know what? Be persistent. Be consistent. You know, it doesn't matter how long it takes. As a matter of fact, the Bible talks about faith and patience, right? And patience is simply to be constantly the same way all the time. Don't change concerning whatever you're believing God for. Don't change. Just stay steady on the word of God. Amen? You know, patience is not the ability to wait. Patience is the ability to wait with a good attitude. You know what I'm saying? That's right. I am being patient. No, you're not. That's not. I'm sorry. Patience is not it's not the ability to wait. It's the ability to wait with a good attitude. That's right. Amen. Hallelujah. I've been waiting so long. All right. Stay with God, man. Praise the Lord. So look at over here at Romans chapter 4. We're going to go over and look at Abraham as a wonderful example of the faith of God. Amen. And he is, like the Bible talks about, the father of faith. And so we can learn from him and many other heroes of faith that the Bible talks about. Going to Romans chapter 4. You know, I started in the first service, and I didn't emphasize it in the second service here, but I'm going to right now. The Bible says, for by grace we are saved through faith. Do you agree? And not of works, lest any man should boast. So the foundation of our faith life should be based always on the grace of God, not on works. And I
trust you are blessed by the message today, and I want to close out this program by giving you an opportunity to make the most important decision you will ever make in your lifetime. I know I say that every time I talk about receiving Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior. And the reason why is because it is the most important decision you will ever make. It affects not only this life, but also the life to come. The Bible says that there's no other way to heaven. You can't get there by being a good person. You can't earn it. The Bible says that nobody is saved by works. It is only by grace. It's a gift from God through faith in Jesus Christ. And right now, if you pray and you call upon Jesus Christ to come into your heart, He will. He will answer. And He will change your life. He changed my life 37 years ago when I called upon Him in that dark place that I was in my life. Suffering from the effects of a drug overdose. I felt like I was going to die and go straight to hell. And I called upon the Lord Jesus Christ to come into my heart. And He did. He touched me. He healed me. And He set me free from all the things that were plaguing me at that time. And I was only 21 years old. So I believe I'm speaking to hearts right now. And there are some of you, you're just so empty on the inside. But God wants to fill you with His peace and His love and His joy. And all you have to do is invite Him in. He doesn't force His way in. He just asks for an invitation. So I invite you right now to pray this prayer. And if you really mean it with all of your heart, God will answer and you will be changed. Pray this right now. Say, dear God in heaven, I come to you in the name of Jesus. And I pray, Lord God, that you will come into my heart through Jesus Christ. I humble myself before you. And I believe that Jesus is Lord. And that He died for my sins. And He rose again from the dead. I thank you, Lord, for hearing and answering my prayer. I declare Jesus Christ as my Lord and my Savior. In Jesus' name, amen. The Bible says whoever says with their heart and believes it that Jesus is Lord and believes with their heart that God raised Him from the dead, they will be saved. Well, that's what that prayer was. It was a proclamation of faith that Jesus Christ is your personal Lord and Savior. We want to know about it. Call us. Let us know what God has done for you. Once again, thank you for joining the broadcast today. We'll see you next week.
And beside the river.
Thank you for watching Demonstrations of Faith, a ministry outreach of Faith Alive Christian Center in Reno, Nevada. If you don't have a home church, we invite you to come and connect with us. We have ministry for the entire family on Sundays at 9 a.m. and 10:30 a.m. and Wednesday nights at 7 p.m. Our Connect Youth Ministry meets on Sunday mornings and Wednesday nights. Child care is available for all services. Our location is 120 Hubbard Way, half block east of the Peppermill in Reno. You can find us online at faithalive.net or by searching for Faith Alive at all social media outlets. Thanks for watching and join us next week for Demonstrations of Faith.
And it's flowing to